Back to my channel, this is Ranjiraj and you are streaming on the Study Beast. So in today's topic I'll be discussing connectivity like a framework or an application, the back-based application called as Firebase. So it is new in the market, it is very hot in the market. So some viewers and subscribers have suggested me to make a video based on this, like how to connect Android to Firebase. So I've listed some points and there are 5 easy steps basically which you want to follow in order to connect Firebase to your Android application. So let's get started. So ready? So first of all, before beginning, like how we connect or how we integrate the Firebase with the Android application, let's have a brief understanding about what this Firebase is. So Firebase is basically a platform for building mobile and web application. It cannot be said that it's pure a database, but it's like a platform, a framework. It is also a database, but moreover it's like a platform where you can create mobile and web applications. Next, you can build data with the real-time data update, and you can store the data moreover in a JSON format, which will provide a tree format structure for easy browsing and for easy navigation as well. And you no need any server configuration for this. Everything is automated by the Firebase itself and no server-side scripting or coding is required. It's time-saving and it's very productive also. And why to use Firebase database? So Firebase database is very quick and simpler to use and implement, and no server-side configuration is needed, no PHP scripts, no database design, no schema-level architecture, nothing. So everything and whole and soul is handled by the Firebase itself, and all the real-time update which were earlier done by the GCM, that is the Google Cloud Messaging Service, is avoided in this. Instead we use the FCM, that is the Firebase Cloud Messaging Service. So this is all about why to use and what is the Firebase, idea to get about what this Firebase actually is. Now when moving to the practical application, like how you can integrate your Android application to the Firebase. So there are basically 2 steps in this. First, you need to create a Firebase application and then you create your Android project. So in creating a Firebase application, there are 5 basic steps, just simple. You just have to log on to the Firebase website. I have put this link in my description. You can go there, and after that you can use your Google login as well to log on to that site, and you can create like it's like a just a dashboard where you get to see some like drag and drop simple stuffs like that. So you can just, it's all simplified. Well, it's like self-learning, you can self-understand what all things you need to input, and after you create all these things, just click on the created application, then you will see all the data and the relevant classes which you have created for that. And after that, on the address bar, there will be an address bar after you create the application. That address bar will contain a URL which you need to include in your Android project for further carrying of the activities. So all these things which I have spoken now, I have included in the description. So just check in the link in the description below. So after you create all the Firebase applications, after you are done with that, then you have to create an Android project, like how you do, like create a studio, like on the Android studio you create like a new project, Android project. Then you need to change the internet permission for that. Earlier you might be using for MySQL or MongoDB or some other databases, but for Firebase especially you need to change the internet permission and configuration for accessing and accepting your Firebase as its backend. Next and third step is you have to integrate. Now third is the most important step, like you have to integrate your Android project to the Firebase. So for that you need to have a build.gradle framework, a file would be there that you have to integrate with the Firebase, and after you do that you have to sync your project with the Firebase which you have created. And once you do that, you have to replace the URL which you have created from the Firebase application and just link it with this application's, and to move it in a like a fluid and fast and fluid manner, so it will all run with the application hand on hand. So you have created Firebase application and you have your Android project, both will go hand in hand with the Firebase as its backend. Now, after you do this, you have to design the UI layout. So for that, you just need to modify your activity underscore mail.